Hey everyone, it's Steph. Welcome to today's video. Today we're going to be chatting about bodyguard romance recommendations. So these are stories where one of the main characters ends up being a bodyguard for the other, and then romantic feelings start to occur, but of course that is not professional, so they have to like keep their feelings under wraps. Then as the story progresses, something changes and the romantic relationship is just blossoming as the story goes on. So these are a few recommendations I thought you might enjoy. Let me know in the comments if you have read any of these or if there are any that I forgot to leave on this video. If you like this video, be sure to give it a like and subscribe to my channel for more fun bookish things from me. And let's dive in. We're going to start off with a book by Becky Wade. This is the end of a family series. All of them are boys except for the youngest, who is a girl. This is called Her One and Only, and this is about a female bodyguard. She is protecting a gentleman. He's an NFL star and he has a stalker. His team hires a bodyguard to protect him, and this bodyguard ends up being a woman. She's a very strong, can hold her own no matter what, definitely the youngest of a family of boys. So we get to see this really great dynamic between these characters. I read this a while ago, but I really enjoyed it, and it's one of the few romances I've read where the female is the bodyguard and she's protecting a guy. So I thought that was really cool and definitely worth recommending to you. Next up we have American Royals. This is basically the concept of if after the Revolutionary War, when America separated from the monarchy in the United Kingdom, imagine that George Washington became the first king of the United States instead of a president. So this imagines that the George Washington family has become this royal family in the United States. So we have three siblings, the oldest of which is going to become the next queen. She has two younger siblings. The oldest has basically been on the straight and narrow path to becoming queen, and she doesn't interact or socialize with many people except for her bodyguard. So there are some romantic feelings there. This is definitely a twisty-turny kind of book. It's told from four different perspectives, and I found the audiobook to be really great, and I didn't want to stop listening to it. Just wanted to just see what happens next, and it is certainly a riveting young adult read if you are interested. Next up we have The Princess Fugitive. This is the second in a series by Melanie Sellier. It's actually my favorite in the series. We have a princess who's grown up in this very strict, harsh environment, reminiscent of the Fire Kingdom from Avatar The Last Airbender. This reminded me of a girl version of Zuko. So if you are a Zuko fan, you might like the story, where she is very much used to being cold and very cut off emotionally from the people around her in order to survive in her environment. There is a threat on the princess's life. So then this leads them on a whole adventure, and the bodyguard is the only one who goes with her. And we get to see how her sense of self and her idea of what her future is changes as the story goes on. It's really well written. I really enjoyed this story and can't recommend it enough. There's a novella that takes place after this where we have other bodyguards who end up falling for each other, which is super cute. It's a short story. I'll put that image here. That is Happily Ever After. And this was so good. Definitely read The Princess Fugitive first before reading the Happily Ever After one, but they were both so good. I really enjoyed the world building, the characters, and the development in these two books. Next up, we have Always. This is the first of a trilogy. It's actually the prequel of a trilogy by Jodi Hedlund. This was so good, so well written, and we basically have at the start of this prequel three princesses who are left orphaned and have to be removed from this threat at the castle. One bodyguard from the castle and one of the lady's maids to the queen have to take these children and get them to safety. They are leaving everything else behind in order to protect the young members of the royal family. We get to see how these two basically escape and what happens to them as they try to keep the royal family safe. A great, sweet romance story. It's a short novella. And then after that, in book three of the series, we get to see them as parents, and we get to see how their role in these children's lives has progressed as they've, you know, become more mature adults, and we get to see their impact on the conclusion of the trilogy. Really great trilogy, but also just a really great romance if you're looking for a bodyguard romance. Last but not least, we have Brass Carriages and Glass Hearts. This is the fourth in a steampunk fairy tale retelling series. So it's a little bit different than my usual read, but I thought this was really well written, compelling characters. I want to say Victorian era England, steampunk world is basically what this world is, where we have this main girl who is sort of like Cinderella, but she's a political activist and she wants to speak up for people who are being discriminated against in their community. He ends up a detective, police officer, some sort of official who ends up having to kind of tame everything down when her rallies and things get too worked up, and he ends up having to protect her on multiple occasions from people who want to silence her voice. So we get to see how these two characters, who are a little bit of an enemies to lovers as well in this story, but a really great, well-written story, and it was one that I just didn't want to stop listening to on audiobook because I wanted to see what happened next. So I really enjoyed that book, and I really enjoyed those on this list. I know it's a short list, but I wanted to give you a few recommendations that I thought you might enjoy. I hope that you find one or two of these books might interest you, might introduce you to something new. If you read any of these, let me know in the comments. I'd love to hear your thoughts on them. And I'll chat with you guys soon in my next video. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.